Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's so good to see you. Now, tonight, I want to let you know that this event is being live streamed onto YouTube, so you will be able to go back and watch it later on and re-enjoy the music. And don't worry, you're not on camera. They've got two cameras. But you might be, because Dakota from City Cable is here, so he might film you. Just saying, so look lovely. You all look lovely. We want to welcome you to Art and Music, which is a part of our city program, Art Lives in Our City. And it really does live in North Richland Hills. And one of our guitarists this evening, Abraham Lopez, actually lives right around the corner here. And you're gonna hear some incredibly talented musicians tonight. We're absolutely thrilled to be working with Texas Guitar Society. And we know that you will enjoy them as much as we do. They are wonderful. Right at this time, I want to honor our 16 visual artists who are going to complement this evening's gorgeous music. And so I would like to recognize at this moment, Selma Aziz. Yes, stand up and please be honored for your beautiful work. Bonnie Binzer. Yes, with her beautiful ballerina, Patrick Brown. There he is. Patrick's piece is right at the end here. It's beautiful. Janet Cunningham. And Lee Davis. And let's all welcome Tanya Harris. And Laura Hunt. And then Pat Kimenow. And Tammy Klipak. And Lisa Martinez, who's also a poet as well as a photographer. And Lee McLaughlin. And Sarah Nixon. Sarah's an art student. She's an art student at UT Arlington. Is that right? That's wonderful. And one of our perennial favorites, Bob Openshaw. F. Robert Openshaw. A wonderful, nationally renowned photographer, you guys. And here he is with us in North Richland Hills. And of course, the great Jack Daw Russell. Way in the back. And another great one, Matt Sachs, Matthew J. Sachs. And of course, our own Darcy, Nancy Billman. These wonderful people, some of them are new to our art programs and some of them are old pros. They've been in our pop-up galleries for several years in a row. If you make art, please, oh please, send your work in when we have another call for our next pop-up gallery, because you are the proof that art lives in our city. All right then. Now I'm going to start winding down so you can hear beautiful music. Before we begin tonight's concert, we'd like to recognize the North Richland Hills City Council, our very own Parks and Recreation Board, and NRH City Management for their support in bringing free arts events like this one to the public. Aren't they terrific? Thank you, your City of North Richland Hills. Our thanks also go to Chelsea, Connie, Elizabeth, and Freddie of the Grand Hall at NRH Center. They laid out all the food for you guys tonight. They arranged the beverage bar. And if you ever have a special event that you want to have primo service on, the Grand Hall is your place. As you can tell, everything from weddings to business events to fabulous music concerts, the Grand Hall is the place that will provide you with an event to remember. Well, the late painter Jean-Michel Basquiat once said, "Art is how we decorate space. Music is how we decorate time." And I can't think of a better group of young musicians than the following young men who are going to entertain you this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the members of the Texas Guitar Society.
So much for coming. Please rise for the national anthem.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for coming in. My name is Abraham Lopez. I'm the president of the Texas Guitar Society, and I am just so happy to see everybody here. Thank you so much for joining us. We are going to now clean a little bit the stage, and we're going to get ready for the show. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you.
Malagueña. Piece, because the piece is called Theme and Variations. So we're going to hear a theme. A theme is a melodic idea. So the composer decomposed this melody, and through each variation, we're going to find that melody. And it's supposed to be interesting for us to try to find the melody. So I'll play the melody once for you, so all of you can get familiarized with it. Okay, so that melody is going to be found all throughout the piece, maybe in the bass. Pam, pim, pam, 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 pim, pam, pam, pim. Okay, so I'm gonna be playing 6 variations for all of you. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is, My name is Ivan Aguayo. I'll be playing two pieces for you guys. Each of them have three movements. A movement is basically kind of like, if you think of an album, it's just different sections of the album. So you can clap in between, but preferably we usually clap at the end of that piece, okay? On the program, what you see for the first piece I'm playing titled Suite Contatos by Paolo Bellanati, you may notice that the order of those three movements is mixed up. It says 1, 3, and 2. That is intentional. That was not a typo. This piece usually has five movements. I'm only going to be playing three for the sake of time. And the second movement sounds like more of a definitive ending, so I hope you enjoy. Suite Contatos. Thank you. Thank you so much. Hopefully that was as fun for you as it was for me. Oh, thank you. So this next piece, all my guitar friends give me a lot of flack because I like contemporary music. Some of it is very, very fun sounding and others is a little bit more aleatoric. I'm kind of like in the middle. So this next composer, his name is Dusan Bogdanovic. He is Yugoslavian, well now Serbia. And he has a lot of Balkan influences in his rhythm, in his music, and you'll hear a lot of that sound in this piece of music. But he was also inspired by African rhythm and jazz harmony. So this piece called Jazz Sonatina is a very, very fun ride. It's almost like you're in a sort of rock metal concert, so brace yourselves. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. How about that Ivan guy? Wow. So my name is Zach Demery. I am the vice president and director of marketing of the Texas Guitar Society. And I would not be doing my job if I didn't say we have CDs and merch after the show available. On that CD is the next piece that I'm going to play. So if you guys like it, you know where to find it. Thank you, guys.
Good evening. My name is Chuck. I'm happy to play for you all tonight. Thank you for listening to us. I'm going to be playing five pieces that I wrote myself. And I'd love to tell you all about them, but, you know, I really don't want to take that much time. So I'd be happy to talk to you about them after the show. But I just want to say they come from different sets of music that I've written, some recently, some about a couple of years ago. But I've just kind of pulled some things that I've been playing lately and put them together in an order that hopefully flows well. So I'm going to play the first two pieces, Preludito and Acceptance, kind of as a set, and then I'll play the last three as a set as well. Oh, and I also want to say thank you everyone who's watching online. That's also very cool. Thank you. Thank you very much. This next piece, song number 3, is what it's called. It's actually a subtle tribute to flamenco music. If you love flamenco, so do I. But man, those guys can play the guitar. But what I've done is try and use some of their beautiful harmonies and, you know, a little bit of references and things like that. The dance number 3 is kind of influenced by modern music. So it has these kind of stop and start types of rhythms, syncopations and things like that. And then the final piece, dance number 4, also very inspired by modern music, kind of heavy metal, to be honest. And I think it served as a good finale to the set. So. Yeah, don't tell my guitar teacher about that last part. Thank you very much. You just never know what's going to happen. Just never know. But it's all right. Thank you.
How's everyone doing? Thank you. The next set of pieces I'm going to play are for the Baroque guitar, originally five sets of double strings. The Canario was a popular dance from the Canary Islands during the Baroque era, and you'll see a lot of Baroque guitarists or composers from that time wrote these Canarios, so I've included two of them. The second one by Gaspar Sanz is the most probably famous one for guitar. Thank you. These last three pieces I'm going to play are based off of Mexican folk music, and it's just three of them. Thank you.
how beautiful was that? The Texas Guitar Society. We've listened to some beautiful music this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your kind attention. Those of you who want to stick around for a question and answer session, this is your chance to speak with these wonderfully talented young men. Artists, you are able to pick up your work. I have your packing materials that I will get for you. You're welcome to, we're gonna make this very informal, but you can pick up your work. But anybody, I encourage you who want to come and speak with the guitarists, here's your chance. I understand Chuck has 60,000 Instagram followers?
YouTube
followers, my gosh. 35,000. I have 15. Yeah. Okay. I think that's pretty impressive. So you guys, they are here. They will take the mic. If you have questions, bring them forward. And the rest of you, we wish you a very happy evening. And thank you so much for being here. Artists, you are able to pick up your work. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you everybody for being here. We just want to give a certificate of recognition to Sarah Green for commemorate the dedication to furthering the artistic community of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. We're so thankful for the support of the Texas Guitar Society. We're gonna give her the Texas Guitar Society CD and a t-shirt too.